We need a lot of insulation in the Arctic. It gets cold here, and currently our insulation, and in fact most building materials, are imported from the lower 48. That's thousands of miles on barges, trucks, airplanes, and can be up to half the entire budget of building a home. But what if there was a way to create insulation locally with roughly the same R value as manufactured foam? Maybe there is.
I'm Filip Mstislavski. I'm professor of public health at University of Alaska Anchorage. The impetus for this work is really to employ biological systems in capturing and storing carbon. So the first step in our process is we take trees that have been beetle killed. We have a lot of them, especially in southeastern and central Alaska, with large bark beetle outbreaks. A lot of these trees can be utilized as a feedstock for our material. We grind them up into a pulp, then we add mycelium culture, mushroom culture, to the process, and we create a foam. Now, foams are great insulators because they trap a lot of air. That's why foamed plastics are so effective in insulating.
So I'm Robin Garber-Slatt. I am a research engineer with the National Renewable Energy Lab at the Alaska campus here in Fairbanks. 80% of your material is going to be pulp or cellulose from the tree. And then we add a small bit of our inoculum, which goes into the very end. We mix it all in, and we pour the foam into a form. And then we take that square of foam and set it in a controlled environment, high humidity, stable temperature, and we let it grow. It grows 5 to 7 days, and then it's a very solid board. Once it's grown, we heat it at a fairly high temperature for several hours, and what that does is it denatures the mycelium. It kills the mycelium, so when it's installed in a building, it won't continue to grow. So the boards that UAA is making, we bring into Fairbanks, to our NREL campus, and we test their R value. We verify that they are actually thermally performing similar to EPS. So we can use them as a one-to-one replacement for EPS in building retrofits. The mycelium that we've tested over the past 2 years has had R values varying from 3.5 to 3.9 per inch. Our goal is 4, so we're very close. So we have our mobile test lab, which has 5 test walls set up to receive our material. We're gonna dry 4 different retrofit ideas, and we're gonna stress it, and we're gonna see how much mold we can grow in a wall if we have this material on the outside. So my ultimate vision is a remote fabrication plant. Can we have a little 40-foot Connex unit that we take out to a rural community? We stuff dead trees in one end, and out the other end comes insulation, and we retrofit every home in the community.